It's nighttime in the big city. That car is still outside. The first ray of sunlight peeks over the Jacquet Mountains. This is Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan.
Welcome to Theme Time Radio Hour. And I don't mean to be an alarmist, but today's show is dedicated to telling you to be careful. We're going to sound the klaxon, put up the yellow perimeter tape, don our hazmat suits, and ride like Paul Revere as we shout dangers afoot. So grab your gas masks, keep your eye on the speedometer, take your Cipro, and stay at a heightened state of awareness. For the next hour, it's going to be fraught with danger. Our first artist, our quartet, formed in Atlanta by Eddie Wallace, John Tennessee Smith, A.L. Smitty Smith, and Ace Richmond. They met while working in a Cincinnati radio station in the 1930s. They started a band called the Red River Rangers. They later changed their name to the Sunshine Boys and scored on Atlanta radio with songs like Lead Me to That Rock, He'll Understand and Say Well Done, and this one, all about the danger zone. Give a listen to the Sunshine Boys in Danger Zone.
If you're off the straight and narrow and you don't know where to turn, when you find that you're a hellbound rolling stone, get back on the glory road, lay down your heavy load,
cause you're
in the danger zone. When you give in to temptation, then you know it won't be long till you nevermore will call your soul your own. Don't let Satan prod you on until you're too far gone,
cause you're in
the danger zone.
Turn back,
or you'll find the devil has a heart of stone.
Turn back,
cause you're in the danger zone.
Make old Satan get behind you when he's holding out his bait. Give in or he will claim you for his own. Better find out where you are before you cross the bar,
cause you're in the danger zone.
When you're shouting hallelujah, you can't hear old Satan's voice, but if you pay heed, you'll go down like a stone. Leave the crooked road behind, don't keep on driving blind,
cause you're in the danger zone.
Turn back,
or you'll find the devil has a heart of stone.
Turn back,
cause you're in the danger zone. When you take the golden highway leading to the promised land, never do you need to fear the great unknown. But you live through the day, you took the easy way,
cause you're in
the danger zone. As you travel on through life, there's only one right way to go. Take the straight and narrow up to heaven's throne. If you turn to left or right, you're heading from the light,
cause you're in
the danger zone.
Turn back,
or you'll find the devil has a heart of stone.
Turn back,
cause you're
in the danger zone.
That was Danger Zone. Eddie Wallace on the piano with the rest of the Sunshine Boys, not to be confused with the Neil Simon movie of the same name. These Sunshine Boys later changed their name to the Light Crust Doughboys, and they patterned themselves after the Sons of the Pioneers. Their radio show was sponsored by Vicks VapoRub, a fine product then and today.
Vicks VapoRub, het goede werkzame medicijn.
Here's a track which is a great snapshot. It's from 1951. R&B was just beginning to turn into rock and roll. The bebop players were still playing in the clubs, and this record has all of it. It's got wild blues guitar, courtesy of Pete Lewis. The horn players are definitely influenced by bop, and the singer, Esther Phillips, was already a seasoned professional, considering she had started 2 years ago when she was 13. Here's our first musical warning, courtesy of the 15-year-old Esther Phillips, and a song called Better Beware. That was Esther Phillips. She went through a lot of changes in her life. She was known as Little Esther when she played with Johnny Otis. Called herself Esther Phillips subsequently. By the late 50s, she was strung out on drugs. She disappeared from the scene for a while. And in 1962, she was rediscovered in a Houston nightclub by Kenny Rogers. This is before Kenny had any hits of his own. He just loved the way she sang. He recorded her doing a country version of the song Please Release Me. It was a big hit, and she had her second career. In 1975, she surfaced again, this time with a disco backing, and another huge hit, her version of Dinah Washington's What a Difference a Day Makes.
I was sitting in my office on that drizzly afternoon, listening to the monotonous staccato of rain on my desktop and reading my name on the glass of my office door, Regnard Kissin.
Animals respond to danger in different ways. Take the possum, or some call it the old possum. When confronted by danger, sometimes it runs, sometimes it climbs a tree. It'll rarely stay in fight. What it does most often is pretend that it's dead. It falls to the ground, its eyes glaze over, its tongue lolls out to the side, and no amount of prodding, shaking, or poking will revive the animal. Not only does it look dead, but gives off a putrid odor that dogs and other predators will abandon. After the predator is gone, it stops playing possum and continues slowly on its way. All animals deal with danger differently, but all of them know to keep an eye out for it. Here's a couple of other guys with the eye of danger. The reggae toasting team of Papa Michigan and General Smiley. Here they are, Eyes of Danger.
Money about the hold of your hand. You call me Noah Algin, about the name of Banche. Noah Algin, about the name of Banche. Got anyway, I'm going money for all the looks.
Bit of the rub-a-dub sound of Michigan and Smiley, produced by Cox and Dodd, Eyes of Danger. You know, it's hard to understand sometimes when those guys really get going. I don't understand the patois totally, but I'm pretty sure I heard them mention the nictitating membrane. I can't be sure, but I think so.
This is Groucho Marx. A few days ago, I was talking with the Director of Civil Defense, and he told me some things that I feel everyone should know. That's why I'm speaking to you now. Did you know, for example, that your chances of surviving an atom bomb attack are excellent? It's true, but there's a big if. You must do everything possible now to help yourself and your family. Nobody else will help you. Listen, because this is important. Keep a complete first aid kit handy. Keep a closed container of drinking water in your refrigerator, enough for 3 days. Be sure you have a good fire extinguisher. Take a look around your house right now and pick out the safest spot. Away from windows and doors. Make sure that every member of your family understands he is to rush to that safe spot when there's danger. I'm convinced that these precautions are necessary right now, and I hope I can convince you. They're important to your family, yourself, and your community.
This is Theme Time Radio Hour, your home for dangerous themes, risky schemes, and menacing dreams. We're broadcasting from the top of the Abernathy Building, traveling through the airwaves on our magical airship, steering through the stratosphere like a coxswain would steer a boat. On our first countdown show, we played Bob DeRoe. It's been a while, so we're going to play him again. This is from his debut album on Bethlehem Records in 1956. He was a big jazz fan and master of vocalese, which is writing lyrics to instrumental jazz solos. Perhaps most famously, in his case, was the lyrics he wrote to Charlie Parker's Yardbird Suite. He got his start being the piano player for the famous boxer Sugar Ray Robinson, who was trying to launch a singing career. A whole generation of kids know him from his songs on Schoolhouse Rock. Here he is, from his debut album, singing about a very specific sort of person, Bob Darrow. You're the dangerous type.
Comes a temptation, I never resist it. Love is a danger, I'm willing to risk it. You are that danger, and danger's why oh you. And so you better not come walking through my door, or I'll throw away the key. You better not go messing around my heart, you'll end up hurting me. You've got the kind of eyes that I could go for. You've got the kind of lips that make me want to know more. And so you better not say nice things just for me, or I'll tumble down. And if you ever smile, that secret smile, that lover's smile, I'll drown. You're just the kind of a girl I always dreamed of, but whom I'd never meet, it seemed. Of course you know that once the flame has started, you got to let it burn and glow, or I'll be brokenhearted. Please say you love me or set me free, 'cause you're the dangerous type of a girl for me. I remember a stranger on the street, and when I saw no ring upon your finger, my heart skipped a beat. So the seeds of love that soon must flower, you got my motor racing 90 miles an hour. I don't believe I ever felt infatuation with such a crazy sting. I had never knew a heaven here on earth where every day was spring. So tell me if there's no hope for my scheming. Pinch me awake, stop this dreaming. Don't you know that once the wheel is turning, acceleration makes it go until the brake is burning. Please say you love me or set me free, 'cause you're the dangerous type of a girl. You're the dangerous type of girl. You're the dangerous variety of female species for me.
From Cherry Hill, Arizona, that was Bob DeRoe talking about the dangerous type. One type that's dangerous is the con man. Here's one of my favorites. His name was Victor Lustig. Perhaps he's most famous for selling the Eiffel Tower. In 1925, he read a newspaper article which talked about how difficult it was for Paris to maintain the tower. He knew everyone was reading the article, so he pretended to be a government official and sent letters to 6 scrap metal dealers to invite them to discuss a possible deal. He told them that it was impossible to maintain the Eiffel Tower. The city would not do it anymore, and they wanted to sell it for scrap. One of the scrap metal dealers took the bait. Lustig took off for Vienna with a suitcase full of cash. Lustig had nerves of steel. He once convinced Al Capone to invest $40,000 in a stock deal. He took Scarface Al's money, then he gave it all back to him and told him the deal had fallen through. Al was impressed with Lustig's integrity and gave him a $5,000 commission. This, of course, was all that Lustig wanted. He was no fool. He knew not to get on Capone's bad side. And he also knew you can't hustle anybody unless they have a little bit of larceny in their own soul. Thomas Jefferson once said, "Eternal vigilance is the price of liberty, and you must be vigilant nowadays." We're going to give you lots of songs that give you specific warnings.
Stop, look, and listen.
Here's a Chicago blues musician by the name of John Brim. We'll tell you about him in just a second. But in the meantime, listen carefully and be careful what you say and do.
Tell me, baby, what is this I hear about you putting me down for someone new? I just wanna warn you before you make a move. Now be careful, baby, what you say and do. You know I ain't mighty bad to have to do away with you. You know I love you, which you know is true. You talk about leaving me for someone new. It ain't no telling what I might do. Now be careful, baby, what you say and do. You know I ain't mighty bad to have to do away with you. You asked me to. I bought your fine car to drive in the place you choose. Now be careful, now baby, what you say and do. You know I ain't mighty bad to have to do away with you. Come here, baby, look me dead in the eye. You know if you attempt to quit me, that's when you're gonna die. Now be careful, baby, what you say and do. You know I ain't mighty bad to have to do away with you.
That was John Brim. Be careful what you do on this action-packed, danger-soaked edition of Theme Time Radio Hour. John's wife, Grace Brim, was a drummer who played with him quite often. I'm not sure if she's on that record, though. He was a good businessman. He owned a dry cleaner and a record store. Was able to make his money on both sides of the record business. If he's remembered at all today, it's because he recorded the original version of Ice Cream Man, which Van Halen covered. We here at Theme Time Radio Hour prefer to remember him for the great records he made himself. It's raining outside the Abernathy building. I came in through the entrance on Rassemble Boulevard. The traffic was backed up. Be careful if you're driving out there. Them streets can get awful slippery. Also, you want to look out for if we had any lightning storms. I shouldn't even be near all this equipment. Lightning can strike the electric wires or phone wires outside and travel along them and zap me through my headphones. I've seen it happen. I ran into John C. Riley on the Stairmaster. I invited him to be on the show. He wasn't going to be around, but he said I could put him on tape. Listen to what he said.
Well, Bob, I don't think I would ever call myself a belt and suspenders kind of guy, just for the crime of fashion that would be. But I think it comes down to, honestly, it comes down to pre-children and post-children. And now that I have children, I don't do things like skydive and scuba dive and whatever, dumpster dive. So, but now that I have kids, yeah, you know, it's really, that's a heavy responsibility, and it's not something I take lightly. You can't You can't go jumping out of an airplane if there's a, you know, a certain percentage of a chance that you're going to die, you know? I got some work to do on their behalf before I deliberately kill myself.
Thanks, John. We were going to play our next song on our smoking show, but it seemed to make more sense here. It was on the Aladdin record label, and you usually think of that as an R&B label, but this was one of the hottest country records back in 1952. It's one of the early forerunners of the whole truckin' music craze, and it's an exciting record that features Speedy West on the steel guitar. It's by an artist who was born with the name Alan Doy O'Dell, but he got rid of that first name and joined Doc Snyder's Texas Cowboys. Wasn't long before he went off on his own and recorded a number of songs. He's also was in the movies, appearing alongside Tex Ritter, Ronald Reagan, James Garner, and Roy Rogers. Here's Doy O'Dell and Diesel Smoke, Dangerous Curves. Look out, Doy.
I'm driving a truck on a mountain road, got a hot rod rig and I'm flying low. My eyes are filled with diesel smoke, these hairpin curves ain't no joke. Diesel smoke, dangerous curve. Out last night drinking beer with the guys, got an aching head and a bloodshot eyes. Ended up with a pretty little dame, I didn't even know her name. Diesel smoke, dangerous curve. I deliver this hotshot freight, I gotta get going cause I'm running late. This mountain grade is mighty steep, I can't stay awake, ain't I had no sleep. Diesel smoke, dangerous curve. I got a gal at the bottom of the grade, she's got the coffee already made. Gotta keep my eyes up on the road, I'm going downhill with a heavy load. Diesel smoke, dangerous curve. Must have closed my eyes a while, cause here I am a-running wild. I burn my brakes and strip my gears, I'm a-gonna have to ride her down, I fear. Diesel smoke, dangerous curve. I should have left the women alone, it's too late now cause I think I'm gone. I got myself in this fix, all because I tried to mix. Diesel smoke, dangerous curve.
From Plainview, Texas, that was Doy O'Dell, Diesel Smoke, Dangerous Curves. A little shout out to all of our friends hauling freight on the highways and byways from coast to coast. Be careful out there, fellas. According to the Bureau for Labor Statistics, highway crashes account for a quarter of all work-related deaths. Truck driver comes in at number 3 of the top 10 most dangerous jobs. The only two more dangerous are logger and Alaskan crab fishermen, and there aren't that many of those. While we're on the subject of blood on the asphalt, let's listen to a song by a guy who comes from Wales. I don't mean that the way it sounds. He comes from Cardiff, Wales. He had a band called Love Sculpture, but this is a song he did on his own. We love him here at Theme Time Radio Hour because he had a top 10 hit with a song originally recorded by Smiley Lewis. And you know how we feel about Smiley. Here's a guy who took a Hear You Knockin' to the top of the charts. Dave Edmonds, with a song written by Graham Parker, Crawling From the Wreckage.
Crawling from the wreckage, to think by now what made the half a brain won't get the message.
Dave Edmonds, Crawling from the Wreckage, from the Repeat When Necessary album. And I hope all of you listening take a lesson from that song. If you're out there driving, buckle up for safety. The safety belt was invented by Edward J. Claghorn. That was back in 1885. The modern safety belt, you know, the one that goes across your waist and crosses your chest, was invented by Niels Bohlen for the Volvo Company in 1958. By 1964, 23 states required seatbelt in the front seat of cars. But it wasn't until 1984 when laws were passed requiring passengers to use them. They say that the seatbelts have saved over 1 million lives in the last 40 years.
Safety, 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 safety.
Do all you can to prevent accidents.
Be sure, be sure, be sure, be sure, be sure.
That when accidents happen,
you have, you have, you have, you have, you have
the best possible accident policy.
Insure, 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 insure.
Here on Theme Time Radio Hour, we scour the globe looking for appropriate songs in the themes which are chosen by you, the listener. Here's today's international selection. It's from France by an artist named Eddie Constantine. He looked like a tough guy and played the Humphrey Bogart-type roles in a series of French films where he played the character Lemmy Cochin. In 1965, Jean-Luc Godard took both Constantine and the Lemmy Cochin character and made an unusual film called Alphaville. It was a futuristic parody of the detective genre. In it, Lemmy Cochin is on a mission. He must liquidate the inventor of a death ray and a supercomputer called the Alpha 60. He must make an intergalactic voyage in his Ford Galaxy. I hope he has seatbelts. This film is more of a spoof and less of the high-minded French New Wave cinema Godard was known for. Here's the theme song from that movie, Hey Mr. Cochin, Eddie Constantine.
Salut Tony, ça t'épate de me voir ici. Dans ta petite tête de crapule, tu pensais que je te retrouverais jamais. Tu vois, c'est pas croyable ce que le monde est petit.
Hi Mr. Cochin.
Voilà, baby, mais juste une minute. Dis donc, Tony, quelle drôle idée de passer ta soirée au pigeon doré. On n'a pas d'idée de venir au pigeon quand on a une tête comme la tienne. Parce que tout à l'heure, ce sera peut-être bien toi, le pigeon.
Hey, hi, Mr. Cochin.
Écoute, mignonne, je t'ai déjà dit une minute. Bye bye, prends un scotch. Je viens tout de suite. Maintenant, Tony, on parle sérieusement. Tu sais, t'as plus besoin de faire le malin. Je sais tout maintenant. tes petits copains, ils font marrer. Ils se sentent tous déboutonnés, tous des lavettes. Tiens, tu mérites bien d'être leur chef.
I said hi, Mr. Caution.
Yeah. T'es drôlement chouette, baby, mais t'es drôlement casse-pied. Tu te poses là, tu m'attends. J'ai tout de suite fini avec ce monsieur. Alors qu'est-ce que tu disais déjà, Tony? Ah oui, t'as compris, Tony, fini la rigolade. T'es fait comme un rat. Alors maintenant tu vas te lever, bien gentiment, et tu vas venir avec moi, sans faire de bruit, et tout doucement.
Oh, Mr. Caution.
Mais il est chaud barre, ce mec, de me parler comme ça. Mais qu'est-ce qu'il me raconte? Viens, chérie, viens. On va aller à la maison. J'ai plein de disques de Tino. On va swinguer.
OK. Bye, Mr. Caution.
Une minute, baby. On voit bien qu'il n'a pas lu le scénario. C'est toujours moi qui gagne.
Oh, Mr. Caution. Oh, Mr. Caution. Ouch. Oh, Mr. Caution. Oh.
Eddie Constantine. Hey, Mr. Cushion. This is Theme Time Radio Hour. All danger, all the time. Let's go to the phones. Hello, caller. You're on the air. What's your name and where you calling from?
Roger Hamilton. I'm calling from Traverse City, Michigan.
Well, howdy, Roger. What can I do for you?
Well, Bob, I've been listening to your show about danger, and I was hoping you could answer a question for me. Back when I was in elementary school, we had a book called Sing a Song of Safety. I can only remember one of the songs from it. It was about ice skating, and it had a line in it, never skate when the ice is thin. The ice will break, you'll fall in. Do you know anything about this book?
Well, Roger, I do. It's kind of interesting. The guy who wrote that book was named Irving Caesar. He was a popular lyricist. You could sing a bunch of his songs off the top of your head. He's the guy that wrote the words to Swanee. T for two. Is it true what they say about Dixie? Just a gigolo. And animal crackers in my soup. I'm just naming a few of them. He was born in 1895. And in 1937, he was looking out the window of his office. He was watching children walking along the streets. He saw that they were ignoring traffic signals and not listening to warnings from their parents. He thought that maybe, if he wrote some songs, the message would sink in. Well, it did, and the songs became very popular. New York Mayor Fiorello LaGuardia, who was named after the airport, brought the songs to public classrooms. Irving Caesar was in a weekly radio show that featured these songs of safety. He must have practiced what he preached, because he lived to be a robust 101 years old. We'll remember Irving, not just for his safety songs, but for all of his songs. Hope that answers your question, Roger.
It sure does, Bob. Maybe you could play one of Irving's safety songs.
Glad to do it, Roger, and thanks for calling. Here then is one of Irving Caesar's songs of safety.
Ice skating is nice skating, but here's some advice about ice skating. Never skate where the ice is thin. Thin ice will crack and you fall right in, and come up with icicles under your chin if you skate where the ice is thin.
Rene Dubois once said, men can escape danger only by renouncing adventure, by abandoning that which has given to the human condition its unique character and genius among the rest of living things. As Daniel Defoe once said, you know Daniel Defoe, he wrote Robinson Crusoe, and I believe he was also in the movie Platoon. Oh no, I'm thinking of Charlie Sheen. Daniel Defoe once said, fear of danger is 10,000 times more terrifying than danger itself. A lot of sirens and a lot of helicopters out there tonight. Like any big city, danger is around every corner here, and we're providing the soundtrack. I was in a record store recently, and I heard this playing, so I picked it up. And it turned out it was a perfect song for today's show. It's a group from England called the Arctic Monkeys, and they've got a song called D's for Dangerous. I have it on good authority that the first draft of this song was called D is for denitrify, which means to take out the nitrogen. Here are the Arctic Monkeys. The Arctic Monkeys, D is for danger. They took care of D. I want to help them out with the other 25 letters of the alphabet. Personally, I think any one of these would be a good song title. A is for acid, B is for bomb, C is for cyanide, E is for electrocution, F is for fence, electrified, G is for guillotine, H is for heroin, I is for invasion forces, J is for jagged edges, K is for kicking mules, L is for lightning, M is for murder, N is for napalm, O is for organized crime, P is for pythons, Q is for quicksand, R is for rustlers, S is for strychnine, T is for TNT, U is for Unabomber, V is for vixens, W is for war, X is for x-rays, Y is for yellow fever, Z is for zeppelins, like the Hindenburg. Dangerous choices all. Here's another choice, the first choice to be exact. A song from the Philadelphia area. It was number 11 on the R&B charts and number 28 on the pop charts. First choice, armed and extremely dangerous.
Stop!
that group was originally known as the Debonettes, but they had their hits under the name First Choice. Armed and extremely dangerous. An interesting thing about armed robbery is that you can be charged with it, not just for having a weapon, but having a replica of a weapon, or something that resembles a weapon. Believe it or not, if you hold your hand in your pocket with your finger extended and pretend you have a gun, you could be convicted of armed robbery. You think it'd be fingered robbery.
Three times the shock, three times the fright, three times the chills in the three spine tinglers that are coming your way now. You'll meet creatures who rise from the crypt in blood of ghastly horror. See the devil's exorcist in Naked Evil and watch inhuman ape creatures carry off pretty young women in Gorilla Gang. Over 4 hours of fright, are you really ready for it? Don't miss the big triple terror show. All color, rated R for adults.
We're talking about danger here on the Theme Time Radio Hour. That's anger with a D. Here's a guy I don't know anything about, Cousin Keith Lloyd. Since we know nothing about Cousin Keith, let me tell you about another famous Lloyd. Harold Lloyd was one of the most famous silent movie comedians. You probably saw him in movies like Grandma's Boy, Safety Last, Why Worry, Brother, and Welcome Danger. That's an appropriate title for today's show. You've seen pictures of him because he did his own stunts in movies. He blew off part of his own hand during an explosion for a stunt he was performing. One of the most famous Hollywood photographs was of Harold Lloyd hanging off the hands of a clock. Anyway, back to Cousin Keith Lloyd. I still don't know anything about him, but I think I stalled long enough that we could play his song. Here he is with Dangerous Crossing.
Better stop, look, and listen. When your heart just won't stay still, better hold it till it will.
Cause there's a
dangerous crossing up ahead.
Now I know all about that girl you're calling your sweetheart. She'll tell you that she loves you and that you'll never part. She'll hug you and she'll kiss you and whisper in your ear. And before you know what's happened, boy, she'll ruin your career. Better
stop, look, and listen. When your heart just won't stay still, better hold it till it will.
Cause there's a
dangerous crossing up ahead.
She's awful pretty and she dresses up so nice. But listen to me, brother, don't look at her twice. Once I led her to the altar, but she says this is the end. She left the church a-running and a-chasing my best friend.
Danger, dangerous crossing.
You better
stop, look, and listen. Heart just won't stay still, better hold it till it will.
Cause there's a
dangerous crossing up ahead.
Cause there's a
dangerous crossing up ahead.
Stop, look, and listen. There's a dangerous crossing. Cousin Keith Lloyd. Well, the basket we put the email in is full to overflowing, so I better pull one out and read it before they all end up on the floor. This one is from an L-O-H-A-N. She doesn't give an address. She writes, "Dear Bob, I wouldn't consider myself a regular listener, but I do enjoy your program when I hear it. I recently was taking some personal time and had a chance to hear the show more often than usual. I understand you're doing an upcoming show on danger, and I thought I would ask you a question. When I was a little girl, I had a Susie Homemaker toy oven. I almost set the house on fire with it. I'm guessing that had to be the most dangerous toy ever made. Am I right? I have a $10 bet with my mother on it. Signed, L. Lohan." Well, L, believe it or not, the Susie Homemaker home oven isn't even on the top 10 list. Here's a couple of the most dangerous toys ever made. The Fisher-Price Power Wheels Motorcycle. If you push the throttle down, it stayed that way. You were stuck in permanent acceleration, at least till you hit a wall. there was a snack time Cabot's Pats doll. This doll would pretend to be eating, but there was no way to turn it off once you turned it on. A lot of little girls got their hair stuck in it. Supposedly, 35 people lost at least part of their fingers, and over 500,000 customers received a full refund. But the number one all-time dangerous toy? Lawn darts. Lawn darts were kind of boring. You played maybe one or two games the way you were supposed to, and then you just threw them straight up in the air and tried to dodge them coming down. Well, you can guess what happened. In their short burst of popularity, there were over 7,000 injuries and 4 deaths. So you might have been a terror with your Susie Homemaker oven, but it was nowhere near as dangerous as some other toys. And none of these toys were made in China. That's a whole other kind of danger. Thanks for your letter, L. Right now we're going to move from L to D. Mercy D, to be exact. His real name was Mercy D. Walton, and he had a very short career. He recorded this song in 1950. He left the music industry by the late 50s, but luckily, Chris Strakowitz, who had the Ahuli record label, tracked him down and got him to record a couple more last sessions before he passed away in December 1962. Like a lot of blues musicians, he recorded the same song a number of times. This is the version he did for Imperial record label. It's called Danger Zone. Here's Mercy D.
This is my final warning, baby. My mind have reached the danger zone. This is my final warning, baby. My mind have reached the danger zone. Oh, before I stand to see you leave me, I would rather see you dead and gone. It makes me bawl just like a baby, just to imagine you with someone else. Just like a baby, just to imagine you with someone else. Oh, say your life wouldn't be worth a nickel. Baby, please don't make me commit myself. Down now, baby. Mama, please try and take it slow. Give me a chance to cool down now, baby. Mama, please try and take it slow. Any move may prove dangerous and cause Crave to be hanging on your door.
That was Mercy D saying, "Baby, please don't make me commit myself." And his mind was in a danger zone. He also recorded at one point under the title Crape on Your Door, after the old tradition of hanging black crape on a mourner's door. Well, one thing we've learned in today's show is that there's danger everywhere. Perhaps no place is more prevalent, though, than the workplace. Fortunately, there's a number of safety films that show workers how to avoid mishaps. This one is called Shake Hands with Danger, and was made for the Caterpillar Company. It was directed by Herc Harvey, who made over 400 industrial films. Also directed the 1962 horror film Carnival of Souls. The narrator on this film was a guy named Charlie Oldfather, who was a professor of law at the University of Kansas, and the film school there is now named after him. Charlie Oldfather wasn't just the narrator of this film, he also sang the title song. Shake Hands with Danger was the most award-winning industrial film of 1980 and was one of only four American-made films selected as the United States entry in the 21st International Industrial Film Festival in Copenhagen, Denmark. Here then is Charlie Oldfather with the title song from Herc Harvey's classic, Shake Hands with Danger.
Hey, turn it over! What if it bumped that control by accident? You'd be mincemeat by now. What have I told you? You don't work on equipment when the engine's running.
Well, I told him not to touch anything. All right, I guess I wasn't thinking.
You weren't thinking? You mean you'll work on engines and machinery and not think of your own personal safety? Here. Shake hands with Danger.
Shake hands with Danger. Need a guy who ought to know. I used to laugh at safety. Now they call me Three Finger Joe. Shake hands with danger. Find it anywhere you choose. Be careless for a moment. Spend a lifetime with the blues. Shake hands with danger. Take a chance that you won't fall. You'll save yourself a minute, but you may damn well lose it all. Glenn doesn't want his friend to sneer at him for being overly cautious. So, Glenn shakes hands with danger. Would have laughed if Glenn had insisted upon playing it safe. But he sure as hell isn't laughing now. Shake hands with danger. Step right up and say hello. Grinding wheels and metal are what made Three Finger Joe. Shake hands with danger. 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 And friends I used to know, compared to them I'm lucky to be just Three Finger Joe.
That was a song I won't soon forget. From the award-winning film of the same name, that was Shake Hands with Danger. A warning to all the working folk out there, here on Theme Time Radio Hour, where danger is our middle name. Actually, Time Radio is our middle name. While we're on the subject of time, the clock on the wall says it's time to go. So until next week, remember to look both ways. And I want to leave you with the words, as I often do, of William Shakespeare, who said in Venus and Adonis, "The path is smooth that leadeth on to danger." We'll see you next week. In the meantime, watch your step.
You've been listening to Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan. Produced by Eddie Gorodetsky, and associate producer is Ben Rollins. Continuity is provided by Eats Martin. Damian Rodriguez was the editor, and the supervising editor was Rob McCumber. The research team is Diane Labson and Bernie Bernstein, with help from April Hayes, Callie Gladden, Terrence, Michael Sharp, Patrick, and Lynn Sheridan. Robert Bauer is the librarian. Debbie Sweeney is the production coordinator. Production assistance courtesy Jim McBean. Special thanks to Randy Ezrati, Coco Shinomiya, and Peter Moldavin, the Kitty Record King. Studio engineers Tex Carbone. Frank's on radio, Lee Abrams. Recorded in Studio B of the historic Abernathy Building. This is a Great Water Park production in association with Big Red Tree. This is your announcer, Pierre Mancini, reminding you to wear a hat. Tune in again next week when our subject is birds.